Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from OneHive Gazette, here with the next video, and in this one we're highlighting some very cool attacks, some swag spells, some swag battle rams, just a lot of cool stuff, and some nice attacks from the war against AxeYouSomethin. Good job to both clans. I think this is one of the better performances from AYS because they've had a few tough weeks, but they actually put up some pretty good numbers, and they did a very good job in our Town Hall 11s getting these guys taken care of in, like, I think around 8 attacks, I want to say. Looks like, well, a few more than that. They took 11, but still 4 for 11, that's definitely above league average. They struggle with 10v10, that was the main difference. We got 2 10v10s, they did not get any. And they also had a few dip fails, but we did a very good job. Another 85 star war, perfect on the 11v10 dips. So that all being said, we're gonna take a look at a few attacks today. I wanna show this one because it was a very nice effort at a Town Hall 11 3 star, and he almost had the juice, just kind of ran out of time. And a few things, if they had just gone a little bit differently, I think this could have been a 3 star. So hopefully I'm not ruining too many of their bases. I did show quite a few of them in the stream, so but it is a CWO matchup, and it looks like, at least for us, every week, gotta have new bases, you know. That's just the reality of being a CWO clan. So taking a look at this attack, he has, I think, 7 healers. He had 6 or 7 healers. One of them was lost to a Seeking Air Mine, so went ahead and threw another one on the Queen. The other healers were supposed to be used on Witches, but he does save one of those healers for some outside Witches. He wants to walk around the outside of the base. Now, the Queen was not supposed to go through this wall right here. We had a very similar base we were doing friendly challenges on. I don't know who the original creator of this base was, but probably not the person who ran it for them in this war. So we were able to practice this on a very similar base, but as you can see, things go differently because the base is a little bit different. The rage and the ability definitely hurt. The rage was too late, that second rage on the Queen. As a result, has to pop the ability, and then it has to use another rage right here. So he's invested a lot in his Queen, more than he should have. If he had just gotten that second rage down earlier, he would still have the ability right now, which definitely would help later on. But anyway, things work out. The Queen staying out of range of the Inferno. She's walking around. Now he's going to wall break the main bowler force into the base. There's that one healer on a few exterior Witches. They're going to kind of walk around the outside, try to clean this up, and get some of those outside defenses as the bowlers move through the middle. Has the jump spell to let them into the Eagle, the Inferno Tower. King getting in there. Perfect Warden's ability. Gets very, very good value from that Warden. Bowlers moving through. Some of them going to cut towards the Town Hall. Others are going to continue around the outside of the base. Now, this Inferno Tower is so low. If that had went down, you can see it's maybe one bowler bounce away from going down right there. If that had gone down, this may have been a different story, but also time is an issue. So if he had the Queen's ability, he might have been able to move through a little bit quicker, but still a few tweaks were needed to make this a 3-star. Only 11v11 attempt we had, and we mainly did this attempt because we did not clear all of the 11s with our 10v11 attacks, and we didn't want to waste any more Town Hall 10s trying to finish off this last Town Hall 11. So we decided to just use a Town Hall 11 attack on it and see if we can get a high 2-star and possibly even a 3-star. And definitely got us a high 2-star, which is important because it made sure we had them on percentage if we tied on stars. So that's why we went ahead and attacked this base with a Town Hall 11, even though we didn't quite clear the Town Hall 10s. So nice attack to Todd there, very close, 83%, good stuff. Let's move on, and 12 and 13 are some Town Hall 10v10 hits. I didn't show them in the stream, so I want to show them in this video because they definitely make the highlight reel. And then we'll get to some Town Hall 9 attacks. I'm going to show 2 Town Hall 9s, some very crazy attacks, some swag stuff, funny attacks we had at Town Hall 9. but we did a very good job. I think we hit it like 75%, which is amazing, especially for us. We typically struggle with 9v9. Our Town Hall 9s went off this war, which was really helpful because we could scout all the upper Town Hall 10s. Actually, all the Town Hall 10s were scouted. This next one by Devin, a nice hog attack here. They had a few small CCs, and we kind of made them pay for it. The king almost walks the wrong way. I think he mistapped the king from what I heard. So luckily that didn't hurt him. The king still goes in, even with the awkward deployment. Pops the king's ability. Great value here. And like I said, not having the lava hound in the CC makes these easier to do just a two golem, bowler, hero, kill squad. You can get so much more without the lava hound in the CC. Right here, the heroes will step up and take out the queen. Meanwhile, here come the hogs. Pretty good spell placement. That first heal goes down to heal them before they get to that inferno. Then some hogs on the outside of the base to kind of help funnel the main group into that inferno. Gets a freeze on the inferno and two Teslas. The hog pathing, not great to the inferno, but at least one group goes in and gets the inferno down right as the other group converges. That way the heal spell is able to apply to all those hogs. He also had a nice skelly spell over the frozen inferno to start to take it out a little bit and distract some defenses. So that's very good stuff. Nice attack to Devin. Hits a few giant bombs at the end, but the hogs can sustain it, and they take out the skellies. That's it. It's a 3-star. Nice stuff. We'll fast forward to the end and take a look at a La Lune 3-star by Smog here. We'll move down one. This is Smog on his Town Hall 10 account. His Town Hall 9 in-game name is Smog, and this is his account DAO, a Town Hall 10 account. And a nice La Lune 3-star. Now, this one did not go according to plan. He actually scouted this on his Town Hall 9 account, and then, based on the scout, just went ahead and did the same plan. But once again, a wall breaker fail. The wall breakers were a little bit weird on the pathing. They kind of went to the wall and then went to the side a little bit. The inferno gets them. He was supposed to get his queen in there and snipe that inferno. But as a result, the queen's going to walk because those wall breakers did not open up that wall. He still gets both air defenses. He probably would have gotten them anyway, but the queen walking ensures that he does get both air defenses and also the king, which can be an issue sometimes, which especially for a skeleton spell on the queen, the king can help guard the queen when the skeleton spell goes down. So that's one benefit of the queen walking, I guess. So here comes the La Lune, very heavy, has a few hounds, hastes, and then a rage on top of the queen. Both skeleton spells. There is a bomb tower, but the bomb tower goes down, so the queen is stuck with all the skeletons and the pups on her. She goes down very quickly. Next haste, those lava hounds just propelled through the base. There's no air defenses left up, so the hounds are just kind of in there with the loons, but has a very effective heal spell. And one more rage over that last bit of wizard towers and archer towers. Then this one group he saved for the inferno is going to come in and grab it. Perfect deployment, gets that inferno. Very important to get that taken out. Don't want that to be the last thing up and have it melt all your loons when they're low on health. Wizard tower will go down right here, and that will be it. That's a wrap. 3-star, nice one to Smog. And let's move on to some Town Hall 9 attacks. The swag show, you could call these Town Hall 9 attacks. The first one's going to be base number 17, just going down a little bit to Mr. Yazbek, and has the battle ram. It's just it's just for show. The battle ram is absolute garbage for attacking at Town Hall 9 because it's meant to be in there for like all Town Hall levels. So it has level 1 barbarians, I think, inside the ram. So as soon as it hits a building, those level 1 barbs come out, and it still takes up like 5 troop space. So it's kind of just for show for these higher level attacks. Yazbek coming in here with a double poison. The CC got a little bit weird because the town hall was in the way, so they kind of went in a circumvent way towards the queen, and he had to go ahead and use both poisons to get them taken out. But luckily the CC does go down. The queen will step up here, and I think he pops the ability to take out the defensive queen. Baby dragon helping with the funnel, and right there pops the ability. She grabs the queen and she'll continue her walk down here. She might be going the wrong way on him. Yeah, I think she is going the wrong way. Yeah, he wanted to funnel her up, I'm pretty sure. So kind of doing some adjustments, but it works out nicely. The queen will meet up with the kill squad. Not too big of a deal. Has the jump. No heals for the hog, so he's has to get very deep with this kill squad. He has the golem, the CC bowlers, the king, some wizards, then two jumps and a rage for this kill squad. So expecting to get very deep into the base. The healers peel off onto the troops, which is nice because he doesn't have to bring a heal spell. Just let the healers get on those bowlers as they go over the giant bomb and stuff. The healers mostly focus on the king, but the bowlers get the splash heal from time to time once they overlap with the golem and the king and all that. So moving through the base here, just this last little bit of wizard towers, but there is a bit of a Tesla farm up here, so he has to be careful. Hogs coming in. They have the king to worry about because his kill squad can't quite reach the king. He might have been a little bit early on the hogs. I would have waited for the kill squad to get through that wall. You can see the healers are keeping them at full health. If he was more patient on the hogs, he could have sent them in right now once the king is engaged. Time was getting low though, so he was trying to do his best to kind of get as much taken out as he could before time got too low to the point where it would be not enough to take out what was left. Wizard on the left side there, starting to try to clean up this base while there's still defenses left up because he knows he's low on time. This one came down to the wire. There's the battle ram coming in there, targeting an elixir collector or something. I don't know the battle ram AI, it's weird, but it ran in there, took out the mortar right here. So the battle ram was supposed to be a swag troop. He was figuring 5 troop space won't cost him the attack if he brings the battle ram instead of an extra hog, but it got close right there, and I don't know, the battle ram actually got on that mortar pretty fast, so funny stuff there. Swag battle ram actually needed to be used for serious cleanup there. So let's move on to the next one here, number 21. This is one of the more extraordinary attacks I've seen. Is this the right base? I think I wrote down the wrong base. Yep, I did. It's supposed to be, I think, Dax, if I'm not mistaken. It's R21, yeah. I wrote down the attacker's number. Yeah, this is the right base. This is Dax 777 coming in here with a hog attack and a few Valks, which I like. Valks at Town Hall 9 as part of the kill squad. Very good for killing heroes, for getting those touching buildings. So comes in with a few golems, the heroes, and some Valks. Gonna jump over the air defense. Goes ahead and just sends a few hogs in to get the CC lure and grab the archer tower there. Also triggers a few spring, or at least one spring trap there. Nice poisons on the queen and the CC. Now the king is kind of acting weird up at the top of the base. Finally the king comes down and will target a golem, so the queen will lock onto him and get him taken out. The enemy queen goes down right there to the king, so getting pretty good value. This is a weird base because the queen is like isolated in that dead zone in the middle of the base there, but gets her taken out with the kill squad. His queen's gonna walk around, grab some of those cannons, then comes in with the hogs here. You can see no spaces for giant bombs really, so they're just getting a little bit of splash damage, a few spring traps, and a few shots from those archer towers, but has quite a few hogs. So this is gonna kind of cut through the base here. Still has 3 heals, only used one of them. Drops that next heal to keep them healed up over the bomb tower expo. Has a few skellies on them, but they're not going to really be an issue. Right here, hit some giant bombs, but they get the last bit of that heal. So they're pretty much back to full health as they go into these last few defenses. The queen is going to meet up with them. Has 2 swag heals. We were on Discord debating where he should drop these 2 swag heals. I was saying to put them like in a corner, or put them on the queen altar or the town hall or something. But you'll see what he does with them here. He waits for the hogs to kind of move through, then puts them on the 2 little top parts